21 professional starts, and Hay didn't in the amateurs. 11-1 he lost in that qualifying tournament for the Olympics.
Halo Sobat Tinju Dunia, jumpa kembali. Kali ini, kita akan melihat sejarah baku hantam berdarah di kelas penjelajah. Pertandingan brutal antara Giacobbe Fragomeni melawan David Hay. Kita berawal mengenal Giacobbe Fragomeni alias Dagu Besi, petarung tangguh yang berasal dari Italia. Di tahun 2006, Fragomeni yang belum terkalahkan dalam 21 pertandingan akhirnya dipertemukan melawan David Hay alias Haymaker, juara pemilik sabuk EBU Eropa di kelas penjelajah. Ini adalah pertandingan pembalasan David Hay karena pernah dikalahkan Fragomeni di kejuaraan amatir.
Qué inmensa nostalgia invade mi pensamiento.
Challenger for the title, please welcome from Italy, Giacobbe Fragomeni.
Saat pertandingan dimulai, di ronde pertama dan kedua, David Hay tampil cukup baik mendominasi pertandingan.
Come out with punches to the forehead, so he may have to try something else.
16-year-old boy marauding forward, getting the gloves up, blocking most of those from Hay as well, Jim, as his fight ticks on.
Yeah, well, that's the biggest question about David Hay. I mean, they've made it pretty public he struggles at the weight. He's missed the scales before.
Professional starts, and Hay didn't in the amateurs. 11-1 he lost in that qualifying tournament for the Olympics. And Fragomeni,
these are the tactics that they've brought as part of the plan. These are good shots from Hay. That one landed on the chin. This is what he needs. Has to find the target, not the forehead.
Again, Hay aiming for the body, but has to take one to the head at the end of the third.
Di ronde ketiga dan keempat, Giacobbe Fragomeni bangkit berhasil tampil sangat kuat, memenangkan ronde ketiga dan keempat.
Can he deliver it when it really matters?
His tactics maybe have to have been changed. This is a good round so far for Fragomeni. He's getting a lot more punches off because he's finding time to do that. A good work there from
his hands. But how tough is it now for him at cruiserweight? I mean, Jim, when you talk
for David Hay, he's been forced onto the defensive. Best round so far, without a doubt.
Fragomeni shakes his head, says he's not hurt. Ian.
Ronde kelima dan keenam, pertempuran brutal dan keras. Haymaker tampil sangat mengesankan, berhasil membombardir Fragomeni, tetapi Fragomeni yang memiliki dagu besi menolak untuk menyerah.
He can take that punch cleanly on the chin there, but he's sucked it up and back he comes. But he's coping with it so well. These are beautiful shots.
Another right hand round the side from David Hay.
We have to remember the good news for Hay is that Fragomeni is not a big puncher.
Di ronde ke-7 dan ke-8, baku hantam brutal terus berlanjut. Fragomeni berhasil membuat pelipis mata kiri Haymaker berdarah. Sayang, Giacobbe Fragomeni kelelahan tak bisa memanfaatkan cedera parah David Hay.
Getting his stuff ready to work. Minute and a half left in the round.
Well, this is just
starting to get excited alongside us.
But all Fragamini is interested in is making that injury worse, and you can't. Big drive here from Fragamini. Just the last thing that he needed. He's just probably boxed the best round of his professional career.
Some durability here. Fabulous action, Jim.
Yeah, this is a tremendous fight.
From that cut by the left eye of Hay. Oh, left hook from Fragamini. Picked that one well.
Weight is probably helping Hay here. That was a good round of fight, picked by far the higher quality punches.
Di ronde ke-9, Dewi Tayo berhasil selesaikan pekerjaannya dengan sangat baik. Bombardir Fragomeni sampai mencari perlindungan di tali ring. Ini adalah kekalahan pertama Degu Besi Fragomeni. Tahun 2008, Giacobbe Fragomeni berhasil menjadi juara dunia setelah memenangkan hitungan juri pertandingan 8 putaran ronde karena luka di mata Fragomeni. Sayang, di tahun 2009, Giacobbe Fragomeni kehilangan gelarnya saat bertarung melawan Slov RDI. Setelah kekalahan ini, karir dari Fragomeni mulai tenggelam. Dipecundangnya oleh Christopher Dakik dan dipukul KO oleh Rakim Zakhiev.
Masina Cakie.
Tahun 2017, Degu Besi Giacobbe Fragomeni akhirnya memutuskan menggantungkan sarung tinjunya dengan tenang. Ya oke sobat tinju dunia, sekian dulu dari saya. Maaf kalau ada kata-kata yang salah. Salam tinju dunia. Semoga Anda semua bisa mendapatkan keberuntungan, kebahagiaan dan kesehatan yang baik selalu.